And I recommend using the second method because it's the quickest and most convenient way to find a light and dark pattern and achieve an artistic, interesting lighting with the neutral light of the interior. Next step is to increase the size of the sun to get soft light from it. And the last thing we need is to catch a light and dark pattern in the most effective manner. So. Hi everyone, it's Render.courses, and in this video we'll figure out how to set day neutral lighting in a matter of minutes. So this is the work of our student. It's made following about the same technology. By the way, subscribe to our YouTube channel and to our Behance. All right, now let's puzzle it out. Now I've got this simple interior scene with a living room and two windows, and we'll set neutral, but at the same time, contrasting daylight. And I hope that it will be interesting. So let's start. So there are two ways of setting the light. In the first case, the fill light is set first, that's the skylight, and then the sun is added. The second way is when we're looking for a light and dark pattern and then we set fill lighting. And I recommend using the second method because it's the quickest and most convenient way to find a light and dark pattern and achieve an artistic, interesting lighting with the neutral light of the interior. And at the same time, it won't lose the contrast of the picture. So let's start. First of all, I'll go to the Corona render settings, and we'll use Corona render in this case. And having opened one of the viewports where the camera is set, we will click this lock. So when we set up the lighting and look for a light and dark pattern, Corona won't switch to the active viewport, which is very convenient. So next I check the single map box and select black color. For now, we reset all lighting settings. The light should be set to default. Now click start interactive and we should have a black render, which means that there's no light in the scene whatsoever. And now we start the stage by stage light setting. All my settings are set to default. Then I need to make the sun. So I go to the Create tab, select Corona, and the drop down list, Corona Sun, and set sun directed towards the interior. Like this. And as you can see, the lighting inside the interior appeared, but of course it's far from perfect. So now let's do some fine tuning. First of all, I'll need my interior with uniform grade material so that materials don't distract us. Because materials often distort lighting. There's a reflection of the light and colors from materials. This makes it very confusing and it's harder to adjust the light. So what I'll do is I'll assign neutral material to all of this. And now we'll go to the render settings tab, check the MTL override checkbox. And now in the non tab, we'll select Corona physical MTL shader. And look what happened. All objects become gray. As you can see, the automatic smoothing of the render takes place and the picture is blurred and we'll lose details. Now, I don't like that, so let's fix this right away. In Corona settings, the performance tab, uncheck fast preview denoise. All right, and here's a small tip. It may be that your light doesn't get into the interior because the glass blocks the light. Now for this demo scene, I just remove the glass, But if you don't want to delete glasses and you need them, you can leave them, but indicate that corona should transmit light inside the interior through the glass. And to this end, you'll need to click Preserve in the Scene tab right here. And check the Preserve Glass Material box and Preserve Opacity box, just in case. This coffee table was supposed to become transparent, but as you see, corona can't understand that this is glass, so just in case, I remove the glass to set up the light. But this is optional. Alright, so we'll set it up. And now we need to achieve a uniform soft lighting, but at the same time, contrast. And let's look at the reference again. There's white light inside the interior. Wow. There are evident shadows in the picture. Now let's try to get the same result. Our sun is too bright, so we have to reduce its light. And we'll go to the Customize tab, and first we'll switch from Realistic Mode to Direct Input, because if we make the sun lower, for example, then the picture turns yellow, orange, and I don't want that effect, so I want my image to always be neutral. So I switch to Direct Input Mode, and the light from the sun becomes white. I will decrease brightness. Let's reduce intensity to 0.5. This value corresponds to the neutral frame buffer settings. And we don't need to set any exposure. This brightness value is enough to get this sun just right. Now, as you can see, the picture is dark, but now it doesn't matter. It's important to achieve a beautiful light and shade pattern from the sun inside the interior so that we have contrasting shadows. But at the same time, the light's neutral. Next step is to increase the size of the sun to get soft light from it. So we need to the direction of the light from the window, but the bright daytime sun shouldn't be obvious. Let's take a look again. This effect is done with the sun, but it seems as if the lighting is overcast. Although this is not the case, let's go back to 3D Max and let's set the size to 32. The maximum value is 64. This way we'll make absolutely blurry lighting. And I think that this is too much actually. And 32 is enough for us. So you can already change the size of the sun and achieve the desired clarity of the shadows in your interior. And the last thing we need is to catch a light and dark pattern in the most effective manner. So my chair is well lit, but the sofa corners are dark. So let's look for a most interesting position of the sun. As you can see, it happens quickly enough in the interactive because only the sun is being rendered. Other lighting elements don't participate in rendering, so setting the light takes very little time. I think that this position is enough. The sofa is beautifully lit. Shadows from the back, from the chair. Everything's in the center. So I think that we'll stop here. Although in your interior, you may still spend a little time searching for a perfect light and dark pattern. But as we can see, our interior remained dark and we need to light it up. So we move on to the next stage, which is lighting with fill light. I'll hide the sun for now. Our render has gone dark again and we'll create the sky. I go to the Material Editor tab, select Shader Corona, Maps, Corona Sky. And now we need to set Corona Sky in the render settings. So we'll check the single map checkbox here. And as you can see, it's black, and we can set the Corona sky map. Drag and drop it here as an instance. All right, and we see our result. Our interior has become blue. I don't want this effect at all. So there are two options. We can pass this Corona sky map through color correction. So make correct and make it neutral black and white, or use raw fake settings. Let's switch to sky model and raw fake and see what parameters it has. As you can see, the color has already changed a little. And we have basic options like ground color, zenith, and horizon. And what's the difference? Now, ground is reflected light from the ground. It affects the ceiling light. It sounds a little strange, but when the light comes from the sky, it is reflected and gives a reflection to the ceiling. So if we change ground color to white, for example, then our ceiling will get lighter. And if we uncheck affected by sky checkbox, then it becomes much more apparent. The next parameter is zenith. This is the light of our sky at its zenith, and it gives a reflex to the floor. So this way we can set the shade of this light on the floor. We can bring it to neutral and keep it delicately bluish. So this way we can adjust the brightness, make it lighter or darker on the contrary. All right, now horizon is the light from the horizon. The penetration of the horizon light into the interior. If I set it to black, our light will become darker in the middle, and I think that we'll make it just neutral gray. And here we have the fill light. By setting zenith, horizon, and ground, we can achieve the desired effect. Make the ceiling and floor lighter, or make the floor darker, and so on. And the last thing is to enable Corona Sun. Let's go ahead and do that. All right. Now, if your picture is too bright, you can reduce simple exposure a bit. For example, do it like this. And now we can see how it looks with the materials. So just uncheck the MTL override box. And voila, we get interior lighting. If you don't like something, you can finally edit the Corona Sun and sky settings, as well as the frame buffer settings. So in short, we can get rid of unwanted overexposure using filming mapping. The highlight compression option appears, and we'll set it, let's say, to 5, and light struck spots become duller. But it seems that our effect is too strong, so let's set it to 0.3, and this should be enough. We can also increase the contrast to 2. Alright, and that's all. So this way we got ourselves a neutral white light, which is also quite contrasting and has shadows. Alright, that's all. Subscribe to our channel. See you in the next video.